Welcome to Heart of the City. I'm Councilwoman Jerry Shipsky, and I represent the 5th Council District, which is on the east side of Long Beach. And today we're going to be talking about a very timely topic. In fact, in today's real estate section of the LA Times, the headline reads, "Prepare for a Quake, LA's Too Busy." And so we just happen to have some very important people here today who are with the Community Emergency Response Team. And I'm going to let them introduce themselves, let you know who they are. I know who they are because one of the first things that my staff and I did is to make sure that we became certified through this program because it's so important. But I want you all to hear in their words because they do this, every week of the year. They're out there in the community doing something related to this program. And so let's listen to what they have to say and why CERT is so important if the City of Long Beach is going to be prepared to really be on its own if we have a massive earthquake. And I know he's shaking his head, so let's talk about that. Tell us who you are and what are you doing in this program?
Okay, I'm Steve Gratch, and I'm the president of the Civilian Board of the Community Emergency Response Team, CERT, as we call it. And I'm retired, and I've been involved with the program for going on 6 years now. And basically,
what is CERT?
Okay, the Community Emergency Response Team goes back actually to the early 1980s. Mm-hmm. Started actually in Los Angeles in response to the great earthquake that occurred in Mexico City.
Right.
And of course, firefighters went down there from the area and came back and said, there were over 800 injuries of first responders who were volunteers who were there immediately from the point when that earthquake happened. And I think the concept was to go out and actually train citizens to at least know where they should be, where they shouldn't be, and to do that. So they started a program which was then later on picked up by the federal government, now under Homeland Security through FEMA. And we are fortunate enough to be a part of the program that's part of the Long Beach Fire Department.
So tell us a little bit, what is the training? How many weeks?
Okay.
What subjects do you cover? Do you make people firefighters out of this?
No, we don't make them firefighters, but I think the best person to describe that is the person here at the end of the couch.
My name is Sybil Kearns, and I'm the Director of Education. I have various duties with the CERT program, but my major responsibilities are seeing that we have a good program put together. We have excellent teachers, our firefighters teach the program, and we also do a lot of work and exposure to the program through events in the city. We have tables where we display some of our equipment and pictures of what we do, and it's quite detailed as to what this program actually does. The thing that impresses me the most about this program is you see people coming into this program a little like, this might be fun. Let's see what we can get out of this.
Well, it was fun.
Yeah.
I have to tell you, it was fun.
we try to put some fun things in there, too. But the thing that I see is when they come out, when they complete the program and they graduate, they walk away and they're walking a little bit straighter because they've got a little bit more knowledge on how to take care of themselves in a disaster.
Let's talk a little bit about how many weeks the program is and just some of the topics that are covered in the evening meetings.
Our topics include basic first aid. We teach basic first aid because the Red Cross is very, very good at that, and we suggest that people, if they want more detail in that program, to go to the Red Cross. But we teach fire suppression. Many people don't know how to use a fire extinguisher. We teach you how to do that, how to put out a fire, and we actually do that. We also teach you how to observe things. We have now a module which we call terrorism, and we didn't like that, but it's necessary in these times to do something in that category. So we teach you how to be observant. There are many other things that we covered: search and rescue, when to go into a building and when not to, how to size things up and not get yourself in trouble so that you can't get out. This should be left for a professional. The program is for 6 weeks. It's one night a week, 3 hours per night. The first half of the class is actually book study from FEMA manuals. And then at the second half of the class, We go out on the field. We train at the fire department training center where all the firemen train.
Actually, that's the fun part.
Yeah, isn't that a kick? But we go out there and we put into practice what we have learned in the classroom, like, for instance, putting out fires. But the program is free. It's backed by FEMA. Our fire department, fire personnel teach the program, and we think it's a wonderful program.
And after people become certified in CERT, what happens?
Well, coming back to it, basically when they finish the program and they are certified, they can go back to their own communities. This particular program fills a function which no other organization fills. As you know, it was mentioned Red Cross, there are other organizations that come in after the fact to a major disaster. What the focus of this program does is it trains people to be self-sufficient themselves and for their family, and if they can, to help their community.
Well, why should we be worried about being self-sufficient? I mean, we've got a wonderful fire and police department with great response time. Why, if we have an earthquake in Long Beach, why should we all be concerned that we won't be able to get them out there immediately?
Well, the first thing is you just look at the numbers. Mm-hmm. This is a city of 500,000 people. Mm-hmm. When you think about a major disaster, there are people in the agencies that you mentioned that are both on and off duty. They have their own families to contend with, and considering the kind of major disaster that we might be talking about, like an earthquake, it may be difficult to get back to their positions. But I know for a fact with the fire department, at any one time, there are 133 firefighters. When you break that down, that's one firefighter for every about 4,000 people. Right. So they're not going to be able